I know, this looks pretty freaky, but what you're looking at is actually a monumental step forward for medicine. Researchers have now created an artificial womb that can successfully keep an extremely premature fetus alive and developing normally. A lamb fetus, that is. The latest development in artificial placenta-based life support technology is an update to something called the ex vivo uterine environment, or EVE. It's a bag that acts as an external womb, providing all the physical support an animal would receive in utero. The hope is that it could provide a more natural, and therefore also more successful, alternative to the incubator, that standard clear plastic box used to hold babies in healthcare environments like the neonatal intensive care unit. See, a typical pregnancy lasts about 40 weeks, and any baby born before the 37-week mark is considered premature. Babies are technically able to survive outside the womb at about 21 to 24 weeks, but that's the extreme edge of viability. Those babies are considered extremely premature. And there's a reason that one of the leading causes of death in newborns is being born prematurely. Babies are really hard to keep alive outside the womb before a certain stage in their development. Even with the advances in healthcare we've seen throughout the last several decades, like artificial airways and better ways to administer IV fluids to infants, infant mortality for babies born before 28 weeks remains as high as 50%. And for babies born on or before that edge of viability, about 24 weeks of gestation, mortality after premature birth is even higher. Those who do survive premature birth are likely to still suffer from lifelong disabilities or chronic health conditions as a result of stunted organ development. So it makes sense that we're looking for a better way to keep babies alive and healthier when really they should still be in the womb. One of the main barriers to a successful artificial womb, which has been the subject of study for over 50 years, is that babies in utero are surrounded by amniotic fluid. That's why their lungs don't work properly before 37 weeks, and instead of breathing, they benefit from a complex shared circulatory system. They're attached by their umbilical cord and the placenta to their mother, whose own heart function keeps the blood flowing between the two, keeping the fetus oxygenated and taking carbon dioxide away. Which is why helping premature babies breathe outside the womb is such a struggle. Existing pumps that keep gases flowing through the baby's body present the problem of damaging its heart, one of the many challenges in healthcare for premature babies. So successful artificial wombs, like EVE, take inspiration directly from nature. They look like a transparent pillow-shaped plastic bag filled with sterile artificial amniotic fluid that gets cycled out, gets filtered, and gets cycled back in. It relies on a novel, gentle oxygenator that uses just the fetal heartbeat to create successful circulation without causing any damage. The fetus receives essential amino acids via IV to replace the nutrients that it would normally be provided by the mother's body, and antibiotics, also via IV, to protect it from infection the way its mother's immune system would. Basically, we've discovered there's no beating the original, so we have to design something that's as close as possible. A team in 2017 kept premature lamb fetuses alive and developing normally for up to 4 weeks in an artificial womb. And in 2019, a joint research team between the University of Western Australia and Tohoku University Hospital in Japan successfully kept extremely premature lamb fetuses at the equivalent of about 24 weeks of human gestation, alive for an unprecedented 120 hours. The lambs even continued to develop wool, just as they would have normally in utero. You may be wondering why scientists are using lamb fetuses. Sheep are actually a commonly used model organism when we study prenatal development, because they go through many of the same processes in the womb as human babies, but they also grow faster than the typical 9 months. So we can study the same stages and mechanisms of development, but at a slightly faster pace. If this artificial womb stuff is sounding science fiction-y to you, it's important to remember that we shouldn't get ahead of ourselves. I mean, for starters, this artificial womb has only been tested so far on sheep, and only on already developing fetuses. To grow a whole animal from scratch, that is, from an embryo, is an entirely different story and something we're really far off from achieving. But hopefully, this technology isn't too far away from being implemented with premature human babies, improving outcomes for preemies and their families all over the world. We have a brand new series that we're stoked to share with you that's all about what goes on in your body when you get sick. And it's called, well, Sick. Beyond treatments and symptoms, we're curious about how exactly viruses, parasites, and other invaders wreak havoc on our health. Check out our first episode on Lyme disease and make sure to subscribe to get all your science news. Thanks for watching.